In this example, we're going to solve a system of equations to work out a word problem. And the first thing you want to do with any word problem is read it and see what you're doing. So it looks like Carl's traveling 4 times faster than Ryan. They're traveling in opposite directions. And at the very end, it's asking us to find their rates of travel. So that's where we're going to start. This is a D equals RT problem. And of those 3 letters, they want us to find the R, the rates. So we're going to set those up. We've got Carl, who's going to assign a rate of X, and Ryan, who we will assign a rate of Y. So right now, we don't know what they are. We know that that's what we're going to find. Carl's going to be X and Ryan is Y. The first sentence also tells us how the rates compare to one another. So if you can, we're going to try to write a rates equation from this first sentence. So take that first sentence down. Carl, he's X, travels, which we could replace with an equals, 4 times faster than Ryan. You can just multiply 4 by Ryan's letter, which is Y. So X equals 4Y represents Carl traveling 4 times faster than Ryan. Now that we have a rates equation, we just need a second equation so that we have a system that we can solve. So let's look at the second sentence. Traveling in opposite directions, they are 450 miles apart after 5 hours. It's looking like they're giving us distance information here. So we're going to see if we can put together a distance equation. That's always easiest if you think about your values in a table. I'm going to make a distance equals rate times time table, and we're going to fill in what we know. So we do know we have Carl and Ryan, and we also know that Carl's rate is X and Ryan's rate is Y. So we can put the X and the Y into the table for Carl and for Ryan. Let's look at that traveling sentence again. We also know that they were both traveling for 5 hours. So you can put a 5 for time for both Carl and Ryan. And as far as their individual distances go, we don't know that, but we do know that we can do distance equals rate times time. So in the table, you can just multiply the 5x together for Carl's distance and the 5y together for Ryan's distance. The original problem also tells us that they are 450 miles apart after they've traveled, so you can just add another box at the bottom of your table and just record that their distance apart is 450. And these 3 pieces of information are going to fit together to give us our distance equation. So let's look at how that's going to work. We do have Carl and Ryan. They're traveling in opposite directions. Carl's traveling a whole lot faster than Ryan. We know Carl's distance from the table is 5x, and Ryan's distance from the table is 5y. We also know that they are 450 miles apart. So it looks like all you have to do is add together the 5x and the 5y to get the 450. So we now have our 2 equations, the x equals 4y and the 5x plus 5y equals 450. And it's set up really nicely for us to use substitution to solve it. So we're going to prepare the first equation and drop that 4y in for x in the second equation. You will multiply that 5 times 4. This is not distributing, it's just multiplying, so it's 20y plus 5y equals 450. Then look at your left-hand side and notice you've got some like terms to put together. 20 plus 5 is 25y. Now on that left-hand side, we need to divide the 25. And that gives us y equals 18. Or since it's a rate, it's 18 miles per hour. And Y was Ryan, so that's Ryan's rate. We've got one of them, we just have to find the other one. So we're gonna take the easiest equation, the X equals 4Y, and then that Y equals 18 that we just found, and just drop the 18 into the Y. That gives us 4 times 18, or 72 miles per hour, and that's Carl's rate, and it makes sense. He's going faster, he's 4 times faster, and when you do the 72 times the 5 and 18 times 5, and you push them in opposite directions, they will be 450 miles apart. So we have solved this problem.